Racing. Never Sabre bustled out of the gates with Gift of the Heart beginning very quickly. They're going to quickly dispute the lead from Heskett. Birdie Eagle coming across now, just in front of On Settling Down with Outrage, and Count the Sessions up there also soon after with Lauren Tinio. In behind them a length and a half off, then Category 3 Settle Down next. Around the outside of them is First Missile. A further length and a half to Secret Identity, Blazing Tycoon, Metallon back in the field, and the last trio were Probity when they got going. The Spruker back there, and last is Fluoro Nero. And so by the 750, Gift of the Heart was able to edge its way clear, drew a length and a half after the battle for the front over Never Sober. Then Birdie Eagle up running third, back on the inside with Outrage, tracking into it beautifully down on the inside of Heskett. Laurentino scouting deep all of the way. Category 3 strung up near the inside, coming to the turn, likewise looking for the way out is Count the Sessions. Around them goes First Missile, followed further back Secret Identity, but Gift of the Heart headed for home a length and a half clear. Never Sober, the run coming full with Outrage down on the inside. Birdie Eagle, Lauren Tinio, Count the Sessions trying to work its way through as First Missile launches. It's coming quickly. Gift of the Heart is the leader. Gift of the Heart a length and a half. First Missile, Gift of the Heart kept going. First Missile with a dive late. Gift of the Heart a foot scrambled home. It's Gift of the Heart just from First Missile. Fluoro Nero charging from the back of the field. Looked as though it might have grabbed third from Heskett. In behind them, Count the Sessions didn't get a lot of room with Outrage, Secret Identity, Blazing Tycoon, the Spruker, Birdie Eagle, Probity next home, Never Sober, Category 3 back there in the field. They're amongst the last group in, and back there with those as well as Metallon. Gift of the Heart. The Quaddy. 10 into 750 for Gift of the Heart, ridden by Matty Derrick, has held on from number 10, First Missile, Sean McGruddy. And third goes the way of, in fact, nine with Outrage, holding third in the photo just in front of Fluoro Nero from last. Coming with a huge performance from back there, 124.02. And it's a short head by a length and a quarter to the final race for the day. Home in 35.33. Gift of the Heart had to fight for the lead, beating off Never Sober, and then was set up to get run down, but has clung on very well. The Great Southerner, by Bradbury's Luck, from Passion Cantata, takes out the last event of the day. First Missile, second in by Smart Missile from Belmont Girl, and third placing going the way of number 9, Without Reg, by War Chant, handled by Jordan Turner. As we head down now to the yard, and here's Lockie after the last.
Thanks, Darren. I'm now joined by winning trainer Roy Rogers. Roy, Gift of the Heart, we've seen previously, just has a really high cruising speed, and that was on display again today.
Yeah, thanks, Lockie. He's been knocking on the door. He's probably unlucky not to beat Count the Sessions a few starts back. Matty elected to ride another horse, 2 kilos might have been all the difference, but today, the sticky gate, I just said to Matty, be very positive, don't hand the lead up, and give him something to chase. He gave a good kick on the corner, and it was a really good ride, good strong left-hand whip as well.
What did you make of the ride, especially in the early stages, drawn out there in barrier 13? Had to do a fair bit of work in the early stages of the race. Were you always confident that he'd have enough in the tank to be strong late?
Yeah, I thought he would. He's done the work, and I waited that extra week to just get those, so he's still a little bit fresher than these others. And in saying that, just don't surrender the lead. He didn't get anyone to annoy him up front, so he had it quite soft, even though he was going, you know, at a good tempo.
As I said, you have to do some work to find the front over 1,400 metres. Do you have any intentions to step him out to 1,600 next start and just hope he gets a little bit easier out in front?
Yeah, I think so. 14, they do go that little bit quicker. And I took your advice, Lockie, and I've kept him in the 14s. So I got a little bit carried away and thought he might stay, but later on. You dare to dream, but if he can do that over a mile, and he's beaten some really good horses today, it'd be nice to see him progress you know, into some of those good races next summer.
Certainly will be. Well done on the win.
Thanks, Lockie.
There's Roy Rogers bringing up a nice win in the last race of the day. Scott, Matty Derrick was very, very aggressive out of the machines, as Roy alluded to, and from there, he made every post a winner.
He certainly did. He never looked back, but they also didn't hand it to Matty on a silver platter. They were making her work from out deep, and in the end, he proves just simply too strong. 14, 10, 9, 11, those numbers. Matty Derrick joins us now. Matty, he did work across from the outside, and there were a few there that weren't going to let you cross too cheap.
Yeah, that's it. I just let him find his own rhythm, and they wanted to kick up inside me. They could for as long as they wanted. I was happy to just have him where he was happy, and eventually they let me cross. So, you know, he's pretty tough. He had to do a fair bit of work from the outside barrier, but, you know, he's tough to the line.
It's great that you can have a tough horse like that so you can ride him with a bit of confidence.
Yeah, definitely. And he's, I think he's quite a progressive horse. Like this, he's only going to get better from here. He's still doing a few things wrong, so I think he's only going to improve with time, and hopefully he can pinch a couple of nice races.
Roy has tried him out over further in the past. Is 7 furlongs as much as he wants, or could he get 1600?
I think in time he can get 1600. He was pretty fresh today, so on a day like today, probably not ideal, but you know, when he's further into his prep and he's a little more settled, there's no reason why he can't find a mile.
Monster Light looks like a nice ride tomorrow for Grant Lahr.
Yeah, he's found a really nice race, so hopefully he can get the chocolates as well.
Congratulations. Well done.
Thank you.
There's Matty Derrick combining with her boss, Roy Rogers, and Gift of the Heart to take out the last of the day. That's all we have time for here at Ascot. So it's good night for our Sky Thoroughbred Central audience. We'll be back at Bunbury tomorrow afternoon.
I'll travel north this way, something